Well, waking up every day and with you in your house is a privilege. It's an honor. And normally I'm doing that from the studio, and we're not really out in the field showing what the weather is like. Now, here on the weather deck, I get to enjoy the sunshine, at least right now, and we enjoy being out of the weather. But a couple of years ago, when Hurricane Isabel slammed the North Carolina coast, that was an adventure to me because I was in the weather, and not only was I in it, I was experiencing a hurricane. And as it rolled in towards the coast of the Outer Banks, we were in Beaufort down in Carteret County, and they were taking a direct hit from the storm, really kind of on the northwest side. It was much worse to our north, but we were experiencing wind gusts of hurricane force. As big as I am, it was shaking me and moving me all over the place. And I looked like a wet spaghetti noodle, basically. And you had birds that were getting slammed into the bay. It was tremendous. We were catching this all live on TV, and we were relaying that information to you so you folks here in the Triad could see what it's like at the coast, even though you were just getting wind and some rain. So that was exciting to me, being able to live that and relay that to what it was like, and to try to be safe at the same time. That was a challenge. A couple of years later, covering the hurricane in the most unique place of all that you would ever guess, the mountains. We went to Asheville to cover, I don't even remember which hurricane it was, and the flooding in Asheville was tremendous, and then I covered that at night when the flooding was starting, and then the next day we had tornadoes that hit the Triad. So that was giving you the coverage across the state of hurricanes in the mountains and also at the coast. And those are my two favorite stories that I've covered in my time here.